quickly create a database that we'll use for WordPress. So what we need to do is we need to be in cPanel, and from cPanel we will go to the databases section and press MySQL databases tab. Once we'll press that, a new tab will open, and from there we'll be able to create a database. And since this database is gonna be for a test database, I'm just gonna call it test.mrwerk.com, which is mrwerk.com is my website. So I'm just gonna create test.mrwerk.com, and I'm gonna hit create database. That will create a database for me. Now I'll take this database name. Actually, I'll just remember it. So now the next step is we need to create a user for this database, so your WordPress website is able to have access to this database. So I'll give it a username. I'll say test user. And I'll give it a password. Great, I have given it a username and a password, and now what I'm gonna do is create the user. Okay, so there's already a user named test, so what I'll have to do is create another user, I guess. Yes, I'll have to create another user. So let's say test.mrwerk.com. Let's see if it likes it. No, it doesn't. So let's make it like that. Let's just generate password, because I wanna have a password that I can use in this video tutorial, because I don't want to share a password that I use in day to day. So this will be our password. I'm just making a quick copy of it. Great, let's try saving this. It's been a little bit slow. Okay, great, we have created our database database user. What we need to do now is we have to go back and then go to the section where we can add user to database. We'll say test.mrwerk.com user, and we want to assign test.mrwerk.com database to it. And this is an important step, I mean, because that's where you give permissions to your table slash database to this user that WordPress will use. We'll say add. And once you say add, it's going to ask which privileges you want to give it. So for WordPress case, you'll have to assign all privileges and say make changes. And that's it. And now your database is all set to go for WordPress. So now what we'll do is we'll go to WordPress, and that's where we wanted to use our, like, that's basically like the WordPress installation page where we want to use these details to be able to install WordPress. So we'll just, since we have all these details like database name, username, password, and database host, which will be just localhost, in this case we'll just use that, and let's say let's go. Now database name was test.mrwerk.com. great. And the username was test.mrwerk.com. And the password was this that we generated. It will be localhost. Now, table prefix is optional. You can change it if you want. If you don't want, you don't change it. I'm just going to call it test in this case. You can call it whatever. And that's how your tables will start. Let's say a new table will be created by WordPress. It will be called test new table. That's how WordPress will create your tables. So I'm just going to say it test. I'm going to submit that. And once that's done, it's gonna ask if you want to run the installation, and it's giving you a confirmation. All right, Sparky. It's saying all's good. WordPress has been successfully able to make a connection.